Hello everybody, welcome to the next session of the Cerumi webinars. Today's topic is hydraulics. Today we will talk about the different impeller forms and the hydraulic forms that you will find in our portfolio in the European market. We will talk about the forms of impellers that you find on our pumps, and we will also talk about some details about the recommendable medium to be pumped with those kind of impellers. So today it will be a combination of a more physical part. I will show you some of the impellers and I will explain you the background, the details, the typical structure of those kind of impellers. And at the same time, we will have a PowerPoint presentation in the background showing you some videos and giving you some arguments about the special points that we need to mention when we talk about the impeller forms, and also about the potential mediums that should be pumped and why they should be pumped with those kind of impellers. So let's directly go to the topic. First, I would like to introduce Cerumi staff again, Susumu Fukuoka behind the camera. Hello, Susumu.
Hello.
And we got Rita in the background. She's just giving a good look to the room right now. And now we will just simply skip to the presentation. May I ask you to focus on the presentation? So if we talk about hydraulics, we always talk about different points. We surely, first of all, talk about the impeller, because this is the most relevant thing if we talk about changing hydraulics. This is the most influencing factor when it comes to the medium that can be pumped or should be pumped. But we also talk about a free passage that is surely defined by the impeller itself. So vortex impeller always offer a bigger free passage than a closed channel impeller, for example. So we will also talk about the pump discharge, and we will have some side hints on the motor. So motor means 4-pole motor, 2-pole motor, 6-pole motor, 8-pole motor, and the different rotation speeds. Because the rotation speed always has a direct influence on the impeller, as this will also define the rotation speed of the impeller surely. So let's go directly to the topic. The first impeller, it's vortex impeller. Vortex impeller is the most easy technical solution, technical design of impellers that you can find. So you have some photos here. You got a cut drawing of a pump with the vortex impeller as well. So if we talk about the advantages of a vortex impeller, we are talking about the impeller with the widest free passage among our possibilities. The impeller that is the most clogging resistant due to the wide free passage, and the impeller that is coming with the highest resistance against wearing. Why is it coming with the highest resistance against wearing? I will show it on example a little bit later on. Just to let you know, the pumping effect of the pump is not done due to the direct contact with the impeller. It is done by a vortex that is created by the rotation of the impeller. So it's an indirect pumping effect created by the vortex that is done by the impeller. Disadvantages are pressure loss, because we're talking about a pump that has a wide free passage, so you will have pressure losses there, and this will just simply result in less flow compared to channel impellers, and less head compared to channel impellers or multi-stage impellers as well. But this is something that I would like to mention as well. We have an impeller design that is offering some advantages, but we are definitely talking about the lowest hydraulic efficiency for the impeller types that you can find. So let's go to a typical example of the impeller. Then I will tell you a little bit more why we should not pump abrasive mediums, for example. Let's go to this impeller. That's the typical design of the impeller. So its shape is usually round, like all the other impellers as well. Then we have the impeller vanes. In that case, it's a multi-vane impeller. You can also have those kind of vortex impellers with only 3 vanes. But the general thing that those impellers have in common is that you have a ground plate, you will have the vanes, and all the vanes are similar orientated, can be different numbers. And this design just simply creates a vortex streaming that is responsible for the pumping effect. So what you can also see on this impeller, you will have an impeller due to the vortex effect that is not in direct contact with the medium. This will be an important point when we talk about the recommended medium to be pumped with this type impeller later on. You will also have a direct effect on the abrasion resistance of the impeller. So the less direct contact you have between an abrasive medium and the impeller vanes, the less abrasion you will have. So let's go to the mediums that we recommend for those kind of impeller forms. First of all, you can see the typical operational mode. So you will have the impeller creating the vortex, and you can see that the material is a bit below the impeller in the wide free passage area, and it's not in direct contact with the impeller itself. So if we talk about the medium, what is recommendable, what is possible? We can surely pump sewage water. Sewage water normally comes with bigger impurities, urine impurifications, larger sized diameter particles. So sewage water is definitely something that can be pumped with this pump with a very wide free passage. You can pump fibrous material, long fibers, because of the lacking direct contact. You can pump bigger solids and abrasive liquids. Bigger solids and abrasive liquids is directly linked to the lacking contact of the impeller. If you have abrasives and a big area of direct contact, you will have abrasion on the impeller as well. This is why this impeller is the most recommendable if you have abrasive liquids. Not possible recommendable in that case, it's clear water, rainwater. I need to explain that a little bit wider. You can surely pump clear water and rainwater with this pump, but it just simply does not make any sense because due to the low hydraulic efficiency, this will be a non-very efficient operation to pump a medium that is not critical with this wide free passage. So for clear and rainwater, we have better impeller forms that we will come to later on. So Tsurumi ranges that are equipped with this impeller, you will see it's a long, long list. So this is one of the most common impellers that we have in our ranges. All the Tsurumi ranges beginning with a U automatically hint on the vortex impeller type pumps. And then we have the smaller pumps, single phase pumps from the sewage ranges, as well as the specialist pump, the titanium pump, the SFP, and the SQ. All those pumps come with vortex impellers. Let's directly go to the next one. So the next impeller type to be discussed is the single channel impeller. So I will combine this point to single channel and double channel impellers, but the arguments for both of them are fairly the same. Let's go to the advantages of a single channel impeller. We are talking about medium free passage. You can directly see it on this drawing here. So you might miss the big free passage that you have seen before in a vortex impeller. So we are talking about the medium free passage here, smaller than the vortex impellers, but still bigger than other impeller forms that we will talk about later. We will have less pressure loss, resulting in a higher flow and a higher head. Disadvantages is that you have the smaller free passage than the vortex pump, for example. And by this, it will be automatically less clogging resistant, and you will have a direct contact with the medium at the impeller vanes, because this impeller is directly pushing the medium away. So we are not talking about the indirect pumping effect anymore. We are talking about the direct pumping effect by pushing the medium. By the direct contact with the medium, we are also talking about a less abrasion resistant impeller form because of this direct contact area. So let's also use an example for that. We have different forms of channel impellers. Let's start with the very easy one. That is a single channel impeller. And if you just take a look at this impeller, you will already see why it's called a single channel impeller. Because the ground structure still is round, like with every impeller, but you just have a single vane going all around through. The medium will come into the impeller, is accelerated in direct contact with the impeller vane, and is then discharged. Here you can also see why we have less abrasion resistance, because we have a wide area within this impeller that is in direct contact with the medium, in direct contact with the abrasive substances, and that can surely wear away at this direct contact positions. So what kind of mediums do we recommend for channel impellers? So that's a point that I would like to mention as well. If we were talking about a low hydraulic efficiency with the vortex impeller, this impeller form comes with a medium hydraulic efficiency. So the duty point will be much more efficient, but you surely pay a price. You have loss in free passage and losses in abrasion resistance and clogging resistance. So here you can see how it's working. The medium is entering the pump, is entering the impeller itself, and is directly pushed away. If we talk about the medium, what is possible, what is recommendable, rain clear water can be pumped, so it's much more efficient than the vortex impeller before. You can pump sewage water, classical sewage water, smaller solids, and fibrous material as well, but in that case we are talking about shorter fibers than for the vortex impeller, just due to the less clogging resistance and the direct contact with the impeller. Not possible recommendable abrasive material, just simply because of the wide area or the big area of direct contact. And please don't take long fibers, because if they enter the impeller, if we're talking about the channel impeller, it might clog the unit. The fibers might also end up behind the impeller and then lead to problems with the pump. So Rumi ranges that come with this kind of impeller type are everything that starts with a B. So the B range, the BY, BP, BY, BY set, BBC, BP set, and also, I wrote it in brackets, the impeller form of the C and the CR series is very comparable to the channel impellers. You can see it here. Let's do a short excursus. If you compare those two impellers, on the first view, you will not be able to see the difference between the channel impeller and the cutter impeller. The only difference is the knife at the end of the cutter impeller. But we will come to that point a little bit later on, just to mention why I put the C and the CR series in the brackets of this presentation. If we talk about channel impellers, we also have to talk about double channel impellers. So double channel impellers are impeller forms that come with more than one vane. It can be a double channel with two vanes, or it can be multi-channel impellers with a lot more vanes. Advantages, if we talk about this form, then we're talking about the lowest pressure loss that you can have with the hydraulics on our pumps, resulting in the highest flow and the highest head compared to the impeller forms before. Disadvantages that automatically come with this are the small free passage, the smallest free passage that you can have in those kind of sewage ranges at least. And automatically the smallest free passage means the lowest clogging resistance. You will have even bigger contact with the medium. The area will be even bigger. So the abrasion resistance of a closed channel impeller types or a double impeller type, multi-channel impeller types is the lowest in the ranges. So this is the pump with the highest hydraulic efficiency, so the best duty point, the highest head in our impeller forms, but surely to be paid with the disadvantages above. So what does that mean for the pump? You can see the drawing here. Everything ends up in the impeller. It's accelerated inside the impeller by the direct contact with multiple vanes and then pushed away. This is having a direct effect on the possible recommendable mediums. Rain clear water, this is the best pump that you can find in our ranges for rain clear water, non-problematic substances. You can also find better ones like multi-channel impeller types, but we don't offer them in our portfolio for the rain and the clear water, as this is just simply not our target group. You can pump sewage water and small solids. What you should not pump is abrasive and fibrous material, because due to the closed construction of the impeller, this is the highest sensitivity against abrasion because of the biggest area of direct contact and also the smallest free passages within the impeller itself, and thus the lowest resistance against clogging. Let's make it clear if we talk about this closed channel impeller. So it's an impeller that is closed at the lower part and that has a smaller opening at the top. And you can see this is a multi-impeller, multi-vane impeller with four vanes. And if you just simply add all the areas of the four veins together, then we are talking about a big abrasive area that is just simply influenced by an abrasive medium very much. But at the same time, I think you can imagine that the bigger the direct contact area and the bigger the pushing effect, the higher the efficiency of the pump from the hydraulic point of view. But you can also see the disadvantages immediately at this impeller. If long fibrous material, for example, ends up in this closed structure, it will just simply clog very, very soon. So, Tsurumi ranges that come with double channel impeller or closed double channel impellers are the BZ and the bigger models of the BY ranges. So, not so many, because we are always talking about critical substances. This is what our target group is, and we don't have many pumps that are really focusing on hydraulic efficiency. So our main focus is a trouble-free operation for the customer and a good product to be very seldomly maintained. Now we come to a different and a special form of impellers. Let's talk about grinders and cutters. I've combined those two impeller forms in one slide because the grinder and the cutter generally have the same function. So the general function should be to cut down, to grind bigger particles that are cuttable into smaller pieces and to just simply pump them away with the pump. So the advantages are the cutting grinding function. You will have a very high flow for a cutter range within our C range, and you will have cutting pumps with a high head. In our portfolio, this means for the GY grinders and the CR, the high head range of the C series that comes with two vanes, a double vein cutter. Disadvantages are the small free passage, but this is the big but in if we talk about cutters and grinders. The small free passage is not really relevant if we are talking about bigger substances that can be cut into pieces. If we have a long fibrous material that is cuttable and confronted with the cutting mechanism, then we are not talking about the long fibrous material after the cutting process. We talk about small pieces that can be pumped easily. What we also have to take care of, small free passage, okay, we relevated that. But we should talk about solids. No solids can be pumped. If we have solid material like stones or sand, this will harm the cutter mechanism. So if we're talking about a medium that comes with high percentage of sand or bigger hard particles, please don't go for a cutter unit. In that case, it would be better to go to one of the impeller forms that we discussed before. We will also have a direct contact with the medium, and solids will surely harm either the cutting mechanism or the impeller itself. So you have already seen this impeller. So it's from the general structure point of view, we are absolutely talking about a channel impeller here with the nice at the end of the impeller. And in combination with the suction plate with some teeth here, it will provide a cutting function. In the end, if we talk about the C and the CR range, this is not a grinding function, that's a cutting function. And the difference to the grinder is that this pump is just ripping the particles or the material into particles that are small enough to be pumped. The grinder itself will create very small particles, so the process is a little bit different. You might be able to understand it better if we focus on the cut samples. So here we have the combination of the cutting impeller with the knife here, and we will have the suction plate with some openings, some teeth, and it will just simply rip off the substances and then they are pumped away. So due to the shape of the impeller, we are still talking about a duty that is quite nice because we can have a duty, a pump duty with a good flow. This is because the C-series combines the advantages of a channel impeller with the advantages of a cutting function. If we talk about the GY, the grinder pumps, you can immediately see the difference here because you have a vortex impeller, so an impeller with vortex shape, a suction plate, and below the impeller you will have the cutting mechanism. And if you consider the free passages that you can see here, this is very, very limited, very small. Those particles that this pump will create are much smaller. So, but due to this very small free passages and this cutting function, you will have a pump that can offer you a big head, but a very low flow. So this means this pump can be preferred if we're talking about smaller diameter pipings in private households, for example, where you will have a cuttable substance that needs to be cut down into small pieces. A big flow should not be done with this pump because the flow is just simply limited to the special grinding function and the result of the small impeller that the small particles created. So generally, I would say we have two pumps with cutting function where the general function is comparable, but the target group is completely different. If we talk about C-series, please keep in mind cutting function, but higher flow, more professional flow, more professional duty points if it comes to the point of flow. The grinders, smaller created particles, higher head, lower flow. So this is again showing what a grinder works like. So you can see it here. The material, the cuttable material comes in. It's grinded into very small particles that are just simply pressed away by the impeller that is located above the cutting mechanism. Medium to be recommended is, I think that's absolutely clear, sewage water with cuttable impurifications, fibrous material. This is where all the cutting pumps, the grinder pumps are normally going to. Not possible recommendable is rain clear water because we can have much more hydraulic efficient solution for that one. Abrasive material due to the direct contact, please don't go with that. And please no solids, sand, stones, metal, something like that can immediately destroy the pump by blocking the cutting mechanism and destroying the pump completely. Tsurumi ranges that come with cutting mechanism are the GY, the GP. G stands for the grinders. So this is your direct hint that we're talking about the grinding mechanism, or the CCR range that are cutter pumps coming from the sea. And those will be preferable if you want to have a bigger duty regarding the flow. So we talked about the classical forms of impellers in sewage pumps now. But as you all know, we are more feeling at home in the contractor pumps ranges. And if we talk about contractor pumps, we always talk about semi-vortex impellers. Semi-vortex is a word creation that is just resulting from the type of the impeller, the shape of the impeller, plus some functions. So let's go into that one. What are the advantages of the semi-vortex style hydraulics that we will find in our contractor pumps? It is clear operation in drainage water is possible. So we can pump sand, silt, small stones, gravel. We can go to various impeller material types. We can go to motors with different pole numbers. So the slower the pump gets from the rotation speed, the higher resistance against wearing. But generally, we are talking about a different medium that we are talking about before. For the sewage pumps, we are talking about something that is just simply poisoning by hard abrasive materials. This is what we're talking about when we talk about semi-vortex. Disadvantages compared with all the impeller types for the sewage pumps that we have seen before, the smallest free passage in this range. So this is just resulting from the factor that we talk about vortex impeller plus suction plate. So the free passage is very small. And we will have a direct contact with the medium all over the impeller and the suction plate. This is naturally coming with the application. You will have an abrasive medium. You need to find a hydraulic that is resistance against abrasion, but that is also directly in contact with the medium that you want to pump. So here you can see it, semi-vortex. That's an HS, medium comes in, it's accelerated and pumped away. Medium that we would recommend is rain clear water, can be done, yes. drainage water, solids, sand, stone, grit, etc., gravel, all those kind of things are recommended when you talk about our contractor hydraulics. What we should not do is sewage water or fibrous material. Due to the reduced small passage and the small dimension strainer stance holes, this pump will immediately clog if you have bigger impurifications of fibrous material. Please don't go for this type if we're talking about a mixed medium of sewage and contractor applications or sewage itself. Why do we talk about semi-vortex? I think we should explain this a little bit further. Semi-vortex, as I said, is a word creation. Let's talk about the KTZ, our best seller when it comes to 400 volt contractor pumps. You can see the impeller. It's a vortex impeller. From the shape, we're talking about the ground plate, plus we can see three vanes. So in that case, the impeller style, the impeller type is vortex. But what you do, you have a suction plate, that's this part, that is in more or less direct contact with a very, very small gap with the impeller itself. What you do, if you combine those two hydraulic parts, you create a closed channel impeller. So from the hydraulic point of view, from the efficiency, we are talking about the efficiency that is comparable to a closed channel impeller. So high flow, high volume, also a high head if you create it in with the vanes in the right way. But we also talk about a material that can resist abrasion. So that's the reason why we call it semi-vortex. The impeller is vortex, but in combination with the suction plate, we are creating a comparable hydraulic to the closed channel impellers. So Rumi ranges that come with this type of construction are more or less all of our contractor pumps. It begins with the small LB and HS, it continues through the LSC, and then all the classical contractor pumps without agitator, NK, KTV, KTZ, KRS ranges. So a special form of the contractor pump, semi-vortex impeller, is the semi-vortex with agitator. So this is an add-on, an additional feature on the semi-vortex concept. The advantages is that we still have an operation in drainage water, that's clear, but we have a big advantage regarding the dry matter substance, the max possible dry matter substances of the pump. So due to the pumping effect with agitator, you will crowden up the medium below the pump, you will unify the medium, and you will be able to have dry matter percentages up to 25%. This 25% is a number for the biggest pump, for the GPN, in extreme conditions. The smaller ones, like the HSD, for example, they come with a lower resistance when we're talking about dry matter percentages. In that case, it might be 7. Then the KRS, for example, comes with approx 15%. But if you want to have more details on that, please consult us directly, mentioning the pump that we're talking about. But generally, the rule is the slower the rotation speed of the pump, if it is attached with an agitator, then we can handle mediums up to 25% dry matter, which is much, much more than the normal semi-vortex without the agitator. Disadvantages: we have, again, a small free passage compared with the sewage pumps. That was the same with the semi-vortex before. And we also have a direct contact with the medium that is even higher because you will have an agitator head rotating in a medium with a high density. So this is the pump or the concept of hydraulics that is the most affected by wear abrasion. And we have some methods to just overcome this abrasional effect by choosing the right materials, chrome cast iron, for example, or reducing the rotation speed of the motor by just reducing the abrasive effect. Let's take a look at the impellers we're talking about. This is quite a big one already. It's coming from a bigger KRS agitator. This makes it clear again. So this is a vortex impeller. Without the suction plate, we are talking about a vortex impeller. if you just consider the suction plate on top of that, you will create a closed channel impeller. And this is the special part that makes it possible to pump a high dry matter substance. So this is usually screwed on the impeller itself. It acts like a steerer. It will steer up the medium. It will create a streaming below the pump. It will create a streaming inside the medium that crowds up the medium, unifies the medium, and makes it possible to be pumped away. So, and you can imagine if this head is running in the medium all the time, this is the part of the hydraulics in the agitator pumps that is mostly affected by abrasion. And this will also be the fact if you have fibrous matter in the medium, this will just simply add up around the agitator head. So please avoid to have our contractor pumps operated in a sewage medium. So this is how it works again. You can see it here, that's what I mentioned. You have an agitator head that is rotating, creating a downward streaming, crowding up the medium, and then the pumps just simply sucks it in and transports it away. A mixture of the dry matter substances plus the medium. Medium that is possible, recommendable is drainage water. We can pump solid sandstones, grit with those kind of pumps. And sludge slurry should be up to 25% dry matter. Please take in mind or keep in mind, 25% dry matter is the maximum that can be done with the biggest agitator pump, namely the GPN, not with the smaller ones. Please consult us if you want to check the values for the smaller ones. Not recommendable, possible, definitely sewage medium or fibrous material because of the simple fact that the pumps will clog very fast. So Rumi ranges that come with agitators. So it's beginning with the small single phase, the HSD. Then we come with the aluminium pump with agitator, KDD2. Then the KTD that is based on the KTZ range in gray cast iron already with agitator. KRS2, the commonly known KRS series with the agitator. And then GPN as the one with the biggest dry matter percentage possible. And then the NKZ, that's the special pump for higher percentages of sand. So last point that I would like to talk about, if we talk about impellers and different hydraulics, we also have to talk about the speed that the impellers rotate in the medium. So what we have in our portfolio is two-pole. Two-pole means rotation speed of the motor approx 2850 RPM. We talk about four-pole, 1450 RPM, six-pole, 960, and eight-pole with 740 RPM. This is all valid for 50 Hertz and three phase motors. 60 Hertz will be different. General rule, the more poles, the lower the rotation speed, the higher the resistance against wearing and abrasion. That's the general rule that you should keep in hand. If we talk about our ranges and would like to divide them into two pole, four pole, six pole, eight pole, you will find most of our products in the two pole motors. So all the single phase pumps come with two pole, for example. Then you have the classical sewage pumps, the grinders, PU, TM, all of them up to 1.5 kilowatts, the C series as well, up to 1.5 kilowatt, then the CR, all the other pumps. So generally, I would say at around 1.5 kilowatt, you will have the border. And from that border on, we're talking about four pole, 1450 RPM. And due to the explanation that I did before, the lower the rotation speed, the higher resistance against wearing, you will logically find all the agitator pumps in the four pole ranges as well, because in that case, reduced rotation speed means reduced abrasion and longer lifetime of the hydraulics in contact with critical medium. If we talk about six pole motors, we only talk about the BUI, the bigger BUI models with 960 RPM. And if we talk about eight pole, this would be a customization that we could in some cases eventually offer upon request, but it's not within our standard ranges. So that's it for today. It was a lot of topic, a lot of value that I tried to transport. If you still have questions regarding recommendable hydraulics for your special application, please don't hesitate to give us a call. We are willing and we would be happy to provide you with any information needed for the right choice of hydraulics, for the right pumps from our portfolio for your application. So thank you very much. See you next time with another topic, hopefully as interesting as that one. Bye-bye.